Okay. So let's go back to the today's contents. Yes, start. Let's start. Today's robot configuration, that is a very interesting part and maybe the important topic of this. Example of robot system, this is shown in the first class. Industrial robot is, looks like this. Robot works by assembling or something. And the condition work piece is detected by some sensors and also the controller, energy source, and some operation device and the networks. Peripherals sensor is also added. So therefore, this is an industrial robot system. And also, some maintenance robot in a nuclear power plant is looks like this. There's also the eye vision for detecting the objects, the target's object, and also the two-hand and movement movement deck, and the communication device, and the remote supervising device, and so on is there. So this configuration of robot system is divided into these parts. Mechanical part, sensing part, processing part, control part, communication part, and power source. Okay? Manipulator for hand, arm. Arm, manipulator. Manipulation arm, robot arm. End effector is end chip. End chip to do some gripping part, or grasping part, or finger, hand, and so on. Okay? End effector. A mobile robot, wheel robot, wheel driven robot, or leg type robot, and so on, is there in some case. And sensor, internal sensor, the sensing itself, the encoder, or potentiometer, or turbo generator to detect the speed. And also external sensor to detect the environment. To detect the environment, the situation, conditions of the working conditions or something is detected for that by using the external sensor. And processing part, signal processor, program is memorized. And the controller, before the controller, some command is calculated. So therefore, some kind of AI technology is used to generate the command. And the communication part is an interface to programming or the supervising about the robot condition by human being. Of course, a network is also necessary in some case, and power source, energy source. All of this is equipped on all of the robot or all of the mechatronic systems. And for the robot, firstly, you have to understand what is the degree of freedom, DOF. Definition is one of the variables required to define the motion of the body in space. これは ISO, GIS, Japanese Industrial Standard definition. Number of independent motion. It means, yes, movement. Some object moves in space. Yes, this is eraser. This movement, this object is moves in space. How to define this motion? Okay. How to define this motion? To find position and orientation. Yes, this eraser is defined its position and orientation. Okay. So therefore, the position is defined by three parameters. For example, translate along x-axis, x-axis, y-axis, t-axis. So the number of degree of freedom for positioning is 3. Okay? 3 parameters is there for the positioning, localization. And then the orientation, the direction of this object. Of course, there are several ways to define the orientation of this object. But for example, the rotate around each axis, each 3 axis. Around x-axis, around y-axis, around z-axis. So the three parameters is there for define the orientation, direction of the object. So therefore, position 3 and the orientation 3. So in total, 6 degrees of freedom is some general object in space. Movement is defined by 6 parameters. Okay. So therefore, to do some task, for example, this object is picked up here to the trajectory by this and put on here in this direction. This work has 6 degrees of freedom. Okay? This work is 6 degrees of freedom. So the in other example, this is picking up and this square's hole, and if it is inserted into square's hole, this work is also 6 degrees of freedom for work. So therefore, object has 6 degrees of freedom, and some work has 6 degrees of freedom. So therefore, to achieve this task, the robot arm to handle or transfer the object in 3D space needs more than 6 degrees of freedom. Okay? Yes, if some transfer task, some object is transferred from the starting point to follow this trajectory to and put on like this. This is the end. So this work has 6 degrees of freedom. Okay? 6 degrees of freedom. This work has 6 degrees of freedom. So therefore, to do this task by robot hands, some robot arm is hold this object and do some task from this fixed on the ground, and this task has 6 degrees of freedom. So that to achieve this task, to carry out this task, this robot arm must have the degree of freedom more than 6 degrees of freedom. At least 6 degrees of freedom to do this task, this robot. Okay? You understand? So the work's degree of freedom, if you find some degree of freedom of this work, task, you must prepare the robot arm more than this number's degree of freedom. Okay, that's one important point. The next, joint. What is a joint? Joint is chemically, it is called pair. Define the connection between two bodies to impose constraints on their relative movement, it says. Joint. So yeah, joint, right? ジョイントは、ジョイントね、で、それは、この、フォア、ベースメントパートと、フォアパートがなんか、リジッドボディ、トゥーリジッドボディ is there, so A リジッドボディ、B リジッドボディ。And this part is a joint, for example.、Okay? Joint makes この these two parts, なんか、relative movement.Something relative movement is generated by this joint part. Okay, so connection between two bodies to impose constraint on their relative movement. The joint makes two rigid bodies relative movement. So the two types of joint.Three kinds of joint,書いてあるけど、スライディングジョイント、 Yes, relatively movement is linear movement, prismatic movement. It's a sliding joint. あとなんかローテーションとかレボリューション。For example, this part is the relatively twisting, or relatively bending motion is also there. So this joint is a bending joint or a twisting joint. Yes, relatively bending or twisting or prismatic linear movement. Then this kind of three kinds of movement, two types, linear movement.Rotation movement. And the symbol, it is described as a symbol. Sliding. This is a like a cylinder. And this rod is moved relatively sliding. And this is also the cylinder. Cylinder is here. And in this cup, in this cylinder, some rod is moved.Right and left. Okay? Or the sliding joint, linear joint, looks like this. And twisting. Twisting or rotate around this axis. This part is one rod is here, and this cone is here, and another cone is here, another cone is connected to this rod. So between these two cones, the twisting movement is happened. Okay?コーンね、コーン。なんだ?このレッドコーンと、レッドコーンとなんだ?ブルーコーンね、ブルーコーンで、こう、レラティブリートゥイスティング。ね?が、トゥイスティングジョイントね、これ。これは、This is shown as these two cones facing to the circular area. Circular area is facing here. であと bending. Bending はなんか two cylinders in the same center of rotation. Center. で、この this rod is left rod is connected to the inner cylinder. Left rod is connected to the outer cylinder. So the two cylinder is here and this is a fixedAnd this part, another part is rotate around this rotation axis.
それはどう書くかといったら、今の様子だと、このアウタースリンダーがこうなってて、アウタースリンダーがこうなってて、インナースリンダーがこうなってて、で、こいつは、ここがセンターアクシス、センターアクシスで、これがこうこう、up and down movement is there. Similarly, this is a top view. Yes, it's okay. Or the left side view. Side view is, looks like this. Some rod is, cylinder is here, and this cylinder is, looks like this. And the center of rotation axis is around here. So therefore, the blue part is rotate around.Like this.
で、これ。これが、this one rod is here. Okay. This is a symbol to show this rotation or this joint movement. で、base. Basement. Ground or basement. And link. Rigid link.
So therefore, as a robot arm is usually the ground, rod, joint, link, joint. This kind of link, joint, serially connected mechanism is a usual robot.Okay, so ground, you have to write ground firstly. And from this fixed ground,
the link is there, rigid body is here, and some kind of joint is here, and then the next link, next joint, next link, next joint, next link, next joint, and finally, some hand or end effector is connected. This is a serial robot, serial link mechanism, is a arm, robot arm, like this, okay?はい、です。というわけで、次のページに何が書いてあるかというと、それは、で、バリアスジョイントって書いてあるのは、Why this various joint? Because this, these, these, this, 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 but it is. よ、これ何これ。ここまでと、What is the difference of the up to here and this and this? What is the difference? これと、これとこれ、これは What is the difference? そんな考えることじゃないじゃないか。これなんかジョイントこう、ジョイントネームなんかぜひ、ジョイントシンボル、ジョイントムーブメントってあるけど、これまあ、プリビアススライド、ベンディングジョイント、トゥイスティングジョイント、スライディングジョイント、I have explained. And this slide added additional differential gear, ball joint. What is the difference? This is also the joint. Joint. What is the difference?ああ、そうですね。よかったね。よかったね。Previous joint, core joint has one degree of freedom. Only single movement is happened between these. グランドいらねえ。この rigid body, joint, rigid body, the bending joint, twisting joint, sliding joint, only doing the one degree of freedom motion between these two parts.で、ディファレンシャルギア、ディファレンシャルギアは、まあなんかこの、インプットです、2インプット。このベベルギア1インプット。ベベルギア2インプット。And this ベベルギア is output part. If you move the same direction, this ベベルギア moves around this axis, around this axis, こう動くと。で、if the first bevel gear and the second bevel gear move to the opposite direction, this gear, output gear rotate around this axis, theta. So therefore, two input, two output, two different kind of motion is generated by using this joint. So therefore, this differential gear joint has2 degree of freedom. もちろん、まあ、入力 2 input, 2 kinds of input and 2 kinds of output. So, differential gear is a 2 degree of freedom joint. And you may understand this ball joint more easily. This is a cup, basement cup.And the receiving the ball is here. So therefore the cup ball mechanism, this cup ball mechanism is do the the up down movement, back down bending, and forward back move bending, and then the rotate around this axis. So therefore this cup ball mechanism joint.このジョイント has 3 degree of freedom. Okay. So therefore the various joint means this is 1 degree of freedom joint. This is 2 degree of freedom joint. This is 3 degree of freedom joint. で、single joint. Joint is connected the two rod, two rigid body. This body, this rigid body.And in this part, this differential gear is also this rigid body, this rigid body is connected by this joint and the ball joint. Of course, this rigid body and this rigid body is connected to this joint, but the number of degree of freedom is different. 1 degree of freedom joint, 2 degree of freedom joint, and 3 degree of freedom joint. Okay? Hi, that is okay. Next. Ah, これは実の。実のデフィニッションは、なんだこれ、グラウンドとか、ムーブメントのエクスプレッションとか、なんだこれ、フィクスチャービトゥインリンクスか、なんかフィクスチャービトゥインリンクスとか言ってあって、で、これがリニアムーブメント、リニアムーブメント&ローテーションとか、ベンディングムーブメントとか、ベンディングムーブメントとか、まあ、リニアムーブメントとか、in some case, twisting is also there, and the cup is also here, and this is a basement. It is detected. It is.あ、こっちあった。ベースにエンドエフェクターとかです。エンドエフェクターですよと。まあいいや。はい。ということで、でロボットメカニカルストラクチャーは何ですかと言ったら、オープンリンクメカニズム、クローズリンクメカニズムっていうのがあります。オープンリンク、シリアリーコネクテッド、アンドオープン。One side is fixed on the ground. The other side is open in the air, open in the space.This is open link mechanism. One end is open in the air, open in the space. And closed link mechanism is looks like this. The one side is fixed in, on the ground, and the other side is also fixed on the ground. Closed loop kinematic chain mechanism. Both ends are constrained to the basement. It's a closed loop mechanism.What is the feature of open loop, open link mechanism and closed link? Yes, closed link mechanism looks like this. Both hand is closed and this part is working. What is the difference? The, yes, one hand mechanism, two hand mechanism. It looks like this. What is the feature of this open link mechanism feature?両、パッこのなんか特徴、クローズリンクメカニズムの特徴、パッツ。
オープンは、エンドチップが先端にしかつかないと、クローズだと、捨てる場所が。
ワーキングプレイスはここか、ここはどこでも使えるということ。まあ、これだって別にここに使ったっていいんだけど、ここに使ったらいい。はい、パッツ。何でしょう。フィーチャー。チューチェン。フィーチャー。オープンループメカニズム、クローズリンクメカニズム。
範囲が大きい。
え
?The reach。
ああ、そうそう。これ、こチューチャーこう、オープンリンクでしょ。だから、Movable area is very wide, widely movement. Relatively, this both hand mechanism is a limited area to move.、Okay? So the、single hand mechanism is more wider. Another feature は Chu Chen.
Another feature.
他のフィーチャー、なんか、わかる You estimate, what's the feature of open loop mechanism and closed loop mechanism?
Closed loop は more stable.
Stable, what's the meaning of stable?
力はもっと強い。
そうだね。Supported by both actuator, so therefore it generates more power.とかね、それはあるよ。シングルメカニズムには、more power is generated here. In addition, open loop is based from only from this ground. So therefore, the open loop part. Open loop, this is open loop mechanism. So therefore the end chip is so flexible. まあなんか soft. But the supported by both arm, this part is more rigid. Okay? More rigid. You can make it more なんか hard. It means more precise control can be executed at this part. The precise positioning or something. But this is flexible, and the chip is flexible. So therefore, it is a little bit contain some error. Roughly, positioning is not good enough, for example, for in some case.だからこっちの方がハード、あ、こっちの方がソフト、フレキシブル、こっちの方がハード、トゥポジショニング。So the, it is not a little bit rough. This is more precisely. ちょっと you must think. Yes, pi open loop mechanism is used. まあ、mainly for the larger range. And the larger range movable area.And closed loop mechanism is why it is used because more rigid, more precise positioning, more power executed, more rapid speed is made in some case. In some case. Hi. Then another categorization is serial link mechanism, parallel link mechanism, serially connected, parallelly connected.Serial link は、I said, I explained in this. Serially connected, serial link mechanism. It looks like this. Yeah. Parallel mechanism is, yes, parallel. Link is connected parallelly. Link is connected parallelly. And this part is do some work. Okay?This parallel link is here and this work. And serial link is serially connected and the here. で、parallel link mechanism, mechanical linkage. Mechanical linkage. Link joint mechanism is the basics of the robot mechanism. ね。で、parallel link mechanism の example は、Stewart platform とかのやつで、まあ、このリニアシリンダーとなんかこのジョイントとリニアシリンダーで This platform is moved. This is commonly used for the, for example, the なんかバーチャルリアリティフライトシミュレーターとかオートモビルシミュレーターとかいうのに使われたりします。It is used for the some simulation. 例えば何これ俺ドライビングシミュレーターね。はい、まあいいや、そういうやつ使われますね、used。で、それから何ですかって言ったら、最近はこの、なんだっけ、デルタロボットとかいうのがあって、こう、パラレルリンクメカニズムは、ピックアンドプレイスタスク、so rapid pick and place task is the useful.So therefore the ADB flex picker is announced is commercially available about 10 years ago and FANUC is also the Genpotsu robot とか yes, this kind of robot is commercially available. So the, for example, pizza making.
L'impianto robotizzato lo vedete alle mie spalle, funziona grazie ad una telecamera posta al di sopra dell'impianto che legge la dosatura del pomodoro, invia queste informazioni ai robot che calcolano le distanze e il tempo in cui far scendere l'utensile e spalmare il pomodoro senza farlo fuoriuscire
白いやつはピッキングパンケーキの方が面白いかな。スピーディングアップ、
Robotics and its strategic partner RG Luma are using robotic technology to transform the production of pancakes. The solution was designed, built and installed by RG Luma to meet Honeytop's own stringent hygienic handling of food, reduced labor costs and improved health and safety levels. Honeytop's pancakes, once cooked, are placed onto a conveyor to help reduce the pancakes to room temperature.Before the pancakes reach the enclosure, a divider pushes the pancakes to either side of the central outfeed conveyor. Then operators manually check the pancakes for consistency. The pancakes are then fed into the robotic enclosure. The enclosure is split into four areas of operation and is comprised of four flex picker robots, four programming and control units, one central outfeed conveyor and two standard conveyors.The pancakes are then ready to be picked and stacked in selectable stack formations on the central outfeed conveyor. The overall system is capable of stacking in excess of 400 pancakes per minute, offering improved cycle times of 20% and an increased payload of 50%. Complementing the flex pickers is ABB's Pickmaster 3.2 software, which helps...
はい、というふうにね、食品の、food.オブジェクトのマテリアルピッキングが来ています。Okay? はい、というわけで、じゃあ次。じゃあさ、メカニズム。メカニズムって話しましたよね。なんか CDR メカニズムとパラレルメカニズムとか言って。で、サムメカニズムズ、ディグリオ、そう。さ、Previously, I said, the joint has three kinds of one degree of freedom joint, two degree of freedom joint, three degree of freedom joint is there.For example, this is 1 degree of freedom, this is 3 degree of freedom, 1 degree of freedom, 1 degree of freedom. For example, in total, this structure, this mechanism has totally how many degree of freedom this robot has? You have to think.、Ne? To calculate this, this is a formula.F is a total number of degree of freedom of the mechanism is.Then, for example, one degree of freedom joint has F number, so it is, looks like this. Two degree of freedom joint has F2 number, it looks like this. And the totally how many number of joint is there? So by using this formula, you can calculate this mechanism's number of degree of freedom in total.で、そう、therefore, I ask you to do this example. これだ。これ、human arm ね。human arm。human arm has, mainly three joints, you think? The shoulder joint, and elbow joint, and wrist joint, and hand, you think?And this is forearm part and upper arm. Forearm part, upper arm part. Okay? Shoulder. ね、で、この this model has, なんだ? まず、firstly, 3 degree of freedom joint shoulder. And elbow part. There are two links in the forearm. ね、で、one is only single one.Degree of freedom joint is here, and the other part is three degree of freedom joint is here, and the other this part is called four degree of freedom joint. This is said. It is because the なんだあこのこっちのパートはなんかボールがあるんだけどボールのカップが this cup is looks like tray ね。So therefore, the not only 3 degree of freedom, but also this cup can move linearly. So therefore, this joint has 4 degree of freedom. Not only ball, but also this ball can move
this direction linearly. So therefore that this joint has 4 degrees of freedom. And then that this list is 2 degrees of freedom, up, down, and right, left. So therefore it has 2 degrees of freedom. And also the each finger has 2 degrees of freedom and 1 degree of freedom. So please calculate how many degrees of freedom this arm, human arm has to do this. Firstly, you should calculate how many 4 degrees of freedom joint is there. How many 3 degree of freedom joint is there? How many 2 degree of freedom joint is there? And how many 1 degree of freedom joint is here? And in total, this mechanism has how many joint is there? Please write. And after writing of each parameter, please calculate this large F. Please do. やるんだよこれ。言ってること分かった？はい。ここの。はい。リンさん、4 degree of freedom joint。How many？ 1ね。これ1。3 degree of freedom joint は？
2。
2か。2だね。2 degree of freedom joint は？
6
だね。で、1 degree of freedom joint は？11だね。で、トータリー、これ3。20だね。で、by using this, these numbers should be input here. はい、入れてください。Please. もう10時だ、30分しかない。30 minutes.ね、計算するといくつになるのこれ。え？はい、答えは33です。33で、で、このアームパートね、アームパート、ショルダー、エルボー、リストまでのこのアップ、アップトゥヒアは7。で、ここのハンドパートが26。And in total, that is.33ね。OK。はい、でした。終わり。はい、次。いいですか ?Move to the next part。33で、アームパートが、ヒューマンアームは7 degree of freedom。You should remember。で、こうなって、なんか2 degree of freedom ジョイントがあって、で、ハンドがあるんだけど、ヒューマンアームは7 degree of freedom だ。You must remember. ね、7 degree of freedom means more than 6 degree of freedom.、ね、more than 6 degree of freedom means we can do this material in space arbitrary, but to the additional one, abundant degree of freedom is added.One degree of freedom is abundant.、ね、so that it is used for some the more precise work or something. Yes, you may understand. I shoulder position connected, fixed, and the elbow, hand position is fixed. But you can rotate this elbow position around this axis. This is 1 degree of freedom. So this is means a 1 degree of freedom is added. Okay. So the human arm has the 6 degree of freedom. 7 degree of freedom. It is the redundant, redundancy. It has some redundancy to do some the work in three-dimensional space. Okay. You should remember. これね、7 degree of freedom。はい、で次が一番重要な。How to decide robot configuration? This is the sample task. これ、this is on board, two-dimensional screen. Two-dimensional screen, this circular object. Circular object is moved to some predefined trajectory.And carry from this part, this position to this B position. ね? This work, this task. How many degree of freedom this task has? How many degree of freedom this task has? This is one disk circle. And circle moves some arbitrary trajectory along this trajectory and move to this position.How many degree of freedom this task has? Two degree of freedom. Because only x-axis, y-axis, we can define this task. Okay? So therefore, what kind of robot arm can achieve this task? At least 2 degree of freedom robot is necessary, okay? To do this task, to hold this disk.And just fixed on this part, on this ground, and this surface like robot. So, this robot must have 2 degree of freedom. Okay? これ書いてある。On two-dimensional task, transfer a circular object from A to B along the predefined path, only position, no orientation of the object. So, therefore, the two-dimensional task. Okay? So, therefore, you need to design 2 degree of freedom robot in here. So therefore, please design 2 degree of freedom to carry out this task as many as possible to write on your note. Okay, please write your note. いいでしょ、うん、はい、ちょっとやってください。 At least three kind of robot you should design. Three kinds of robot to do this task. なんかこうハンドがあって、でなんかメカニズムがあって、リンクジョイントメカニズムがあって、 At least two degree of freedom joint link メカニズムね。Please write as many as possible to achieve this task. 返っていこう。Please write one of them. Please. Any of them is all right. Please write. あ、どこでもいいよ。Okay. Anything.This idea is the bending, なんか bending the linear and bending. Now, of course, the, なんだっけ、もう一個、例えば、違うなんかさ、linear and linear joint is also there. で、まあ、それは2 degree of freedom. So, therefore, the, 何Bending joint and linear joint combination is at least this.、ね、というわけで、例えばこれは、ね、例えば only one single joint is used. This is link, and this rotation joint is used. Yes, it can do that, but to the only this trajectory. So therefore, the only single degree of freedom robot is good enough to the outer movement on this plane.、Okay? So therefore, you should add additional one. For example, not only this rotation, but also this prismatic joint is, if we add this prismatic joint, you can change the trajectory. So therefore, any arbitrary trajectory can be achieved by this 2 degree of freedom joint.For example. And also, this robot is also can be done. Yes, this prismatic joint and this prismatic joint, 2 degree of freedom joint. If you change this length, if you change according to this length, so you can put this hand, center of hand to this here, okay? Any part.Two translation joint is also there. And also, for example, this rotation joint is also good. Rotation joint is good to do this task. Yes, this robot is good, of course. This prismatic joint robot is good. So, therefore, I have shown like this.For example, these three robots can achieve this task.、Yeah? The same task can be achieved by using the 2 degree of freedom robot. 2 degree of freedom robot. One is a rotation prismatic. One is prismatic, linear. And one is rotation, bending. And I want to ask you, what is the best answer to achieve this?What is best? Which is best?
Three.
Three? Three means all of them is okay? Fine.
Only the third.
Only?
The third method.
Third method? For third method here is good. The best you think? Five it is.じゃあ聞こう。で、多分ファーストアンサーね、セカンドアンサー、サードアンサー。Who think the first one is best? Yes, yes, okay. Yes, four. じゃあ、セカンドワンイズベスト。サードワンイズベスト。Yes? Yeah, thank you. I think the all of them is good. But I ask you to remember which is the best is depending on the conditions or priorities. So to think about that, you should think, what is the characteristic of this mechanism? What is the characteristic of this mechanism? What is a good point and the disadvantage of this mechanism? You should think. So therefore, for example, this mechanism, what is a good point? What is a good point of this mechanism? Naga, who? Ami, you said this is the best. Why this is selected as best? あとは何か言うか、what is your answer? What is the characteristic of this mechanism? このメカニズムのグッドポイントは、グッドポイントはね、well, only this part can move. It means small footprint. The moving part is only inside of this.So therefore, it's very compact to achieve this task. Compact. Very, very compact. That is one important characteristic. Second mechanism. What is the second mechanism? It's a good point, bad point. No one said this is the best. But what is a good point of this mechanism? What is a bad point of this mechanism? Bad point maybe this is a large, very large mechanism and the area of movement to occupied area is very large. So therefore, not good enough. But to the good point, one good point is this is, for example,You should set this is x-axis, this is y-axis. You define that this trajectory is x-y parameters. Only x-y parameters is inputted into this actuator. Only that you can control this robot. So therefore, the easy to control. And also, the linear actuator makes more power than rotational actuator in many cases.And the precision, the linear movement is more precisely you can do in some case. So therefore, the precision and the power is good of linear actuators, linear motions. Control is easy. No sine, cosine calculation is necessary. Only x, y parameters is applied to this movement. So therefore, the easy to control.That is one good point of this robot. But the footfall tracing part is very wide, so that it's not good in some cases. So how about this? How about this robot is a good point? That is a good point.これはオブスタクルアボイダンス。For example, some obstacle is here. This bending mechanism can reach to the beyond the obstacle. Behind the obstacle, you can reach. So that is one important point, obstacle avoidance. But the sine, cosine, arc sine, cosine, you have to calculate.So therefore, a little bit complex compared to this robot. And so therefore, if the precision is the priority, you should select this robot. More flexible operation, you should select this. The small tracing area, this robot should be selected. So the engineer, designer,Should think, yes. For this, for example, you should think the candidate as much as possible, as many as possible. And then after that, you should think, yeah, this mechanism's feature, characteristics, and then in this case, the precision is important, occupied area, small occupied area is important, or some flexibility is important. So depending on its constraint, you should pick up best selection, best way to achieve the task. That is one important point, I think, for engineers designing something. Okay, this is a very, very important point. Important thing through this topic, I think. Okay. Hi, the similar way is looks like this. Yes, this is also the two-dimensional plane on the plane task. But this is a square, and so the orientation is also important to keep this orientation. To do this task, this task, how many degrees of freedom this task has? Not only position, but one orientation parameter is necessary. So therefore, the 3 degrees of freedom task it is. So therefore, you need a 6 degrees of freedom robot. So therefore, the 2 degrees of freedom robot is not good enough because the orientation is defined by this mechanism. It's not good. So therefore, the added 1 degree of freedom to tune the direction of the object orientation is used. Okay? Additionally, not only 2 degrees of freedom, added 1 is used for the tuning the direction of object. So the similarly, that looks like yes, it's not good enough. So therefore, the additional 1 degree of freedom, 3 degree of freedom robot can do that. Oh, okay, ne? Then, industrial robot arm classification. There are basically 4 types. Or that is you must remember. 4 types of robot is there. Cartesian robot, XYZ linear motion robot, rectangular robot. Secondly, cylindrical robot, cylindrical coordinate, rotation, linear movement, cylindrical coordinates, 3 parameters. And polar coordinate robot is here, the basement rotation, bending, and prismatic. Then rotation 2 and prismatic. The spherical coordinate, polar coordinate. And then the third articulated robot, anthropomorphic robot, is 3 rotation joint is here. So the industrial robot, these 4 kinds of robot is used regularly, usually. Okay? 4 kinds. And then parameter is XYZ parameter. これは cylindrical parameter だから R theta Z, R はこれ、length.Arm length, and Z is height, and theta is rotation of basement. And then this coordinate is theta phi psi, R theta phi. Arm length to theta phi. And then the third one is here, XYZ rotation, etc.First theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 rotation is there. Okay? で、次は何だっけ？これだ。カルテシアンコーディネートは、XYZ ね。で、シリンドリカルコーディネートは、なんだ？ R theta、R theta Z ね。で、バーサトロンロボットは、one of the first industrial robot, the first commercially available. And spherical robot は、R theta phi, R theta psi か。で、Unimate, one of the first industrial robot commercially available is this coordinate system. And articulated robot, まあ、バーティカリーアーティケイトロボット theta, theta, theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. It's used. And some little bit special type is the horizontally articulated type and the parallel robot is also there, but the skip today. This part is skipped. So, these four industrial robots. What is an important point of this? So what is the common part of this? この I said the 何rectangular type, a rectangular type, spherical type, and the cylindrical type, and articulated type. I said I introduced these four types as a basic industrial robot configuration. And what is the common characteristics of this? That is, how many number of joints is there? How many number of joints is there? I said three parameters, I said three parameters, I said three parameters, I said three parameters. So therefore, all of this configuration has 3 degrees of freedom. So the 3 degrees of freedom joint, three degrees of freedom mechanism. And what is its task? What is its task? By using this 3 degrees of freedom, by using this 3 degrees of freedom, by using this 3 degrees of freedom, what happened? はい。これは to decide least position in 3D space. For example, this robot, Mars.3 degrees of freedom robot is looks like this, and this robot is decide these positions, this position in 3D space. Okay, this position in 3D space. For this robot, rectangular robot, this position, この end tip position in 3D space is decided by this 3 degrees of freedom.このロボット、this robot, spherical robot. この these positions, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 joint, decide this least position.、Okay? And this robot, this cylindrical type robot, rotation, linear height, arm length, decide this position, least position, この least position.So therefore, the 3 degrees of freedom is used for the positioning of in 3D space. Okay. It means some 3 degrees of freedom mechanism is here. So 3 degrees of freedom mechanism is decide its position. And then the many robots add 3 degrees of freedom.To this list, and then it decides the hand orientation in 3D space. Then many of the robot has 3 degrees of freedom as make this list positioning, and additional 3 joint is used for the hand orientation in many cases. Okay.So therefore, these four types, 3 degrees of freedom arm is the basics of industrial robot. Four types, 3 degrees of freedom mechanism. Okay, you should remember this. Okay. はい。というわけで、あとはなんかここにペイロードウェイトインダストリアルロボット、これはちょっと a little bit old type. But this is a present available robot in, 例えば for example, this is a Mitsubishi robot. And the maximum reach of radius, this position is looks like this. And the maximum payload, load capacity looks like this. So therefore, the, this area is present commercially available robot. This is depending on the, of course, material weight is also necessary, but the mainly depending on the actuator power. Yeah. Electrical motor, mainly the AC motor is used presently to the robot joint actuator. AC powers self weight and output power ratio of output power per self weight is very important to decide the robot's performance, radius, maximum payload. はい、ということで、大体終わって、これでおしまいか、human robot の、what is the difference human robot and specialized robot? Specialized mechanism. It is set, but skip. Okay. Afterward, maybe I will explain the data process. Okay?